Dear friends, we never have a dull moment on our branch line. Thomas was silly and got into trouble, so a diesel rail car called Daisy came. She caused trouble, but has now our promise to be good. So the Fat Controller has kindly given her another chance. Meanwhile, Toby chased a ball. Percy got into a predicament and... But you must read the stories for yourselves. The author.
Stop, Thomas, laughed his driver. You could almost manage it without me. Thomas had become conceited. He didn't realize his driver was joking. Later, he boasted to the others. Driver says I don't need him now. Don't be so daft, snorted Percy. I'd never go without my driver, said Toby earnestly. I'd be frightened. Boasted Thomas. I'm not scared.
You'd never dare.
I would then. You'll see.
The next morning, the firelighter came.
Thomas drowsed comfortably
as the warm spread through his boiler.
Percy and Toby were still asleep. Thomas suddenly remembered. Silly stick-in-the-muds, he chuckled. I'll show them. Driver said I could manage without him. I'll just go out. Then I'll stop and whoosh! That'll make them jump.
Thomas thought he was being clever. Really, he was only moving because a careless cleaner had meddled with his controls.
He soon found his mistake. He tried to whoosh, but he couldn't. He tried to stop, but he couldn't. He just kept rolling along.
He didn't dare look at what was coming next.
There was the station master's house.
The station master was about to have breakfast.
Horrors! Cried Thomas and shut his eyes.
The house rocked.
Broken glass tinkled.
Plaster was everywhere. Thomas had collected a bush on his travels. He peered into the room through its leaves. He couldn't speak.
The station master was furious.
His wife picked up her plate. You miserable engine, she scolded. Just look what you've done to our breakfast. Now I shall have to cook some more.
She banged the door. More plaster fell. This time it fell on Thomas.
Thomas felt depressed. Workmen propped up the house with strong poles and laid rails through the garden. Meanwhile, Donald and Douglas arrived.
Dinner, fast yourself, Thomas. We'll soon have you back on the rails, they laughed.
Managed to haul Thomas back to safety. Bits of fencing, the bush, and a broken window frame festooned his front, which was badly twisted.
The twins laughed and left him. Thomas was in disgrace. There was worse to come.
You are a very naughty engine.
I know, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
Thomas's voice was muffled behind his bush.
You must go to the works and have your front mended. It will be a long job.
Yes, sir.
Meanwhile, a diesel rail car will do your work.
The diesel, sir?
Thomas spluttered. Yes, Thomas. Diesels always stay in their sheds till they are wanted. Diesels never gallivant off to breakfast in station masters' houses.
Percy and Toby were worried. Thomas's recent accident had caused a great deal of trouble, and the Fat Controller was waiting for them with important news.
Here, he said, is Daisy, the diesel rail car, who has come to help while Thomas is indisposed.
Please, sir, asked Percy. Will she go, sir, when Thomas comes back, sir?
That depends, said the Fat Controller. Meanwhile, however long she stays, I hope you will both make her welcome and comfortable.
Yes, sir, we'll try, sir, said the engines.
Good. Run along now and show her the shed. She will want to rest after her journey.
Daisy was hard to please. She shuddered at the engine shed.
This is dreadfully smelly. I'm highly sprung, and anything smelly is bad for my swerves.
Next, they tried the carriage shed.
This is better, said Daisy. But whatever is that rubbish?
The rubbish turned out to be Annie, Clarabelle, and Henrietta, who were most offended.
We won't stay here to be insulted, they fumed.
Percy and Toby had to take them away and spend half the night soothing their hurt feelings.
The engines woke next morning feeling exhausted.
Daisy, on the other hand, felt bright and cheerful.
Ooh, ooh,
she tooted as she came out of the yard and back to the station.
Look at me, she purred to the passengers. I'm the latest diesel, highly sprung and right up to date. You won't want Thomas's bumpy old Annie and Clarabelle now. The passengers waited for Daisy to start, but she didn't. She saw that a milk van was about to be coupled to her and was most indignant.
Do they expect me to pull that?
Surely, said her driver, you can pull one van.
I won't, said Daisy. Percy can do it. He loves messing about with trucks.
She began to shudder violently. Nonsense, said her driver. Come on now, back down.
Daisy lurched backwards. She was so cross that she blew a fuse.
Told you, she said, and stopped.
Everyone argued with her, but it was no use.
It's fitter's orders, she said.
What is?
My fitter's a very nice man. He comes every week and examines me carefully.
Daisy, he says, never, never pull. You're highly sprung and pulling is bad for your swerves.
So that's how it is, finished Daisy.
Stuff and nonsense, said the station master.
I can't understand, said the shunter. Whatever made the Fat Controller send us such a feeble,
spluttered Daisy. Let me.
Stop arguing, grumbled the passengers. We're late already. So they uncoupled the van
and Daisy purred away, feeling very pleased with herself. She could now enjoy her journey.
That's a good story, she chuckled. I'll do just what work I choose and no more. But she said it to herself.
Toby the tram engine has cow catchers and side plates. They help to prevent animals from getting hurt if they should stray onto the line. Daisy thought Toby's fenders were silly.
You're afraid of getting hurt yourself, she flounced.
I'm not, huffed Toby.
Yes, you are. I don't have stupid cow catchers, but I'm not frightened. I just toot and they'd all go away.
But they don't, said Toby.
They would with me. Animals always run if you toot and look them in the eye.
Even bulls?
Even bulls, said Daisy. Daisy had never met a bull, but she purred away quite unconcerned.
She tooted at a farm crossing and a horse and cart halted while she went by.
She said, it's easy. I just toot and they all stand aside. Poor little Toby. I'm sorry he's frightened.
At the next station, a policeman was waiting.
There's a bull on the line, he warned. Please persuade it to return to the farmer.
Daisy was excited. Now, she thought, I'll show Toby how to manage bulls.
Champion isn't really a fierce bull, but this morning he was cross. He'd strayed from his field, crashed through a fence, slithered down a slope, and now he didn't know where he was. Suddenly, he saw some grass.
Now for my breakfast, he thought.
Tooted Daisy. Go on.
Champion was too busy chomping to take any notice.
Ooh, said Daisy again.
Champion kept grazing.
This is all wrong, thought Daisy. How can I look him in the eye if he won't turn around?
At last he did.
Ooh, said Champion.
Ooh, oh, murmured Daisy. Why doesn't he run away?
Gone, Daisy, said her driver. He's harmless.
Yes, said Daisy unhappily. You know he's harmless, and I know he's harmless.
But does he know?
Look at his horns. If I bumped into him, he might hurt me, them. The farmer wouldn't like that.
Champion sniffed at Daisy.
Ugh, said Daisy. And that was that. Daisy did no more.
Toby was bemused and amused to see her back in the station so soon.
Bulls always run if you toot and look them in the eye, eh, Daisy?
Daisy stayed silent.
Ah, well, continued Toby, we can live and learn. I'd better chase him away for you, I suppose. He clanked away to find Champion.
Toby's bell rang and his whistle sounded, but Champion took no notice. Then Toby whooshed loudly. That did the trick. Toby whooshed a little more. And now, breakfast over, Champion chuntered away to join the farmer. Daisy was feeling exhausted. She was glad when her day's work was over. Some boys were on the platform.
Look, Daisy, one teased. I've got some sweets. They're called bullseyes. I like them. Do you?
Keep your old bullseyes.
And Daisy scuttled to her shed.
Daisy, the diesel rail car's work in the countryside, was full of surprises. She was frightened of bulls and cows, and she remained very lazy and stubborn. One day, Toby brought Henrietta to the station, where Percy was grumpily shunting. Hello, Percy. I see Daisy's left the milk again.
I'll have to make a special journey with it, I suppose. Anyone would think I'd nothing to do, grumbled Percy. Tell you what, replied Toby. I'll take the milk. You fetch my trucks. The drivers and the station master agreed. Percy had never been to the quarry before. He began ordering the trucks about. Hurry along, he said. The trucks grumbled to each other. This is Toby's place. Percy's got no right to poke his funnel up here and push us around. They whispered and passed the word. Hey, Percy, out! Hey, Percy, out! Come along, puffed Percy. No nonsense. We'll give him nonsense, giggled the trucks. But they followed so quietly that Percy thought they were under control. Suddenly, they saw a notice ahead. All trains stop to pin down brakes.
Beep, beep, beep.
Brakes guard, please. But before he could check them, the truck surged forward.
On, on, they cried. Help, help,
whistled Percy. The man on duty at the crossing rushed to warn traffic with his red flag, but was too late to switch Percy to the runaway side. Frantically trying to grip the rails, Percy slid into the yard.
Beep, beep!
Look out!
The brake van was in smithereens. Percy's driver and fireman had jumped clear, but Percy was stranded. Next day, the fat controller arrived. Toby and Daisy had helped to clear the wreckage, but Percy remained on his perch of trucks. We must now try, said the fat controller, to run the branch line with Toby and a diesel. You have put us in an awkward predicament. I am sorry, sir, replied Percy. You can stay there till we are ready. Perhaps it will teach you to be careful with trucks. Percy sighed. The trucks groaned beneath his wheels. He quite understood about awkward predicaments. The fat controller spoke severely to Daisy, too. My engines work hard. I send lazy engines away. Daisy was ashamed. However, Toby says you worked hard after Percy's accident, so you shall have another chance. Thank you, sir, said Daisy. I will work hard, sir. Toby says he'll help me. Excellent. What Toby doesn't know about branch line problems isn't worth knowing. Our Toby's an experienced engine. Next day, Thomas came back. And Percy was sent to be mended. Annie and Clarabel were delighted to see Thomas again, and he took them for a run at once. All are now friends, and Toby has taught Daisy a great deal. She shooed a cow off the line all by herself the other day. That shows you, doesn't it?
Lost and let down. Seems like those dark skies are following you around. And life's just one big shade of gray.